Hi everybody, I'm Christine. Welcome back to Cabin Creek Homestead. I have my oldest daughter with me out here with the tomatoes to do some tomato maintenance, and she's really glad to be here with me instead of inside the air conditioned with her brand new books, right, Joelle?
Not really. I'd rather be inside, but
nerd! Really glad to have her out here with me today in the vegetable patch because I planted over 30 tomatoes. They are growing exceedingly well and it's time to do a little bit of maintenance on them. So all I'm going to do today is prune up the tomatoes. It's quite easy to prune a tomato, and if you stay on top of it, it's something that you can just add into your regular garden maintenance and not get overwhelmed by it. I'll prune off the suckers and I'll show you what that is and how to do it, and I'll be putting straw around them to help keep moisture in and act as a mulch. And then when my husband gets home, he doesn't know this yet, but he's going to be installing our Florida weave system. That is how I'm going to be She laughs at me. A Florida weave is a really great way to stake up your tomatoes. Tomatoes want to grow flat along the ground like a vine, but we need them up off the ground to keep moisture off of the leaves and prevent fungal and pest issues. So we're going to be staking them up, not with a tomato cage like a lot of people like, but tomato cages, they just really don't do it for me unless they were homemade tomato cages that are about 10 feet tall. But instead, what we're going to try this year, because all of our tomatoes are in a nice long row, is the Florida weave. So let's get started. You ready? You got your sunscreen on?
No.
Oh, here. So let's take a look at this plant. Right here, we have a nice long stalk, and then we have these perpendicular leaves right here. Every once in a while, coming off the plant at a 45 degree angle is a very tall stalk, and that is a sucker. This wants to grow into its very own plant. And in fact, if you wanted to cut it, you could root it in water and grow your very own plant out of it. I don't need to do that at this point right now. So all I'm going to do is come to all of them and prune off these suckers. So here's my next tomato plant. And you can see that there are a lot of leaves here touching the bottom. These are very unhappy leaves because water bounces up off the ground, gets them very wet, and we are just inviting all kinds of fungal issues. So these bottom leaves are going bye-bye. So here's another example of a nice tall stalk, plenty of perpendicular leaves branching off from right there. But in this little crook right here is a small branch starting to grow. This is a sucker. With these really tender ones, all you have to do is pull them off by hand. If it gets ahead of you a little bit and they get really thick, you can clip them off with your clippers. So look right here. I have this upward branch and then the perpendicular leaves going. And right here at a 45 degree angle, another sucker. So I'm just gonna use my fingers, pinch that off right there. Ta-da! Now this tomato plant is all cleaned up and starting to put on some flowers. All right, so I am going to get started pruning the bottom leaves off of all these tomato plants and pinching those suckers off. Coming behind me, my daughter is going to put straw down around the base of the plant, and that is going to help keep moisture in, and it's also going to stop all this red clay from splashing back up onto the plant when we have a heavy rain or when the sprinkler system is going. So, here we go. I think I'm on my own for the rest of the project because their daddy just called saying that he bought a little inflatable pool. But I don't mind, this is really fun. Although it is very sunny, it's not a very hot day, so it's a nice day to get some work done out here. Pruning these up makes them look like a completely different plant. Let me show you what it looks like. Here we have a tomato plant that is unpruned and it has branched and forked off in so many directions. It's difficult to find the main plant that I planted. But right next to it, I have brought this one back to a single stem and taken off all the suckers. taking any part of a plant off of the whole plant itself feels counterintuitive. It seems like you're hurting the plant, but there are a lot of things that can encumber growth. Even if it's a good thing, too much of a good thing can cause problems. And the goal of this plant is not to be big and bushy. The goal of this plant is to produce fruit. And taking away what the plant is spending too much of its energy on is actually helping it to produce fruit. I love the analogy of how that applies to our spiritual lives and to who we are as a person. There's a lot of things in life that really suck away our energy, and we can waste our sorrows on a lot of things that don't actually produce fruit. And as I'm sitting here pruning the suckers off of these plants and feeling the pain of cutting back what looks like a good thing, I'm wondering in my own mind, like, what are the suckers in my life? What is stealing my energy, or what am I wasting my sorrows on? Or am I spending energy in an area of my life that is actually not gonna bear fruit? So these are the hard questions that pop up in my mind as I'm gardening. So there, now you have those hard questions. So you have fun struggling with that. I'm gonna keep trying to find the center of this plant. Wow, that was a giant sucker. Anything coming off that plant at a 45 degree angle, that really wants to be its very own plant. Aha. There's a baby one forming right there. Well, two unexpected helpers joined me in the tomato patch today, so this job got done a lot faster than I thought it would. So all I did was prune the bottom branches off, prune the suckers off, and they put some straw all around the base of the tomatoes. So hopefully the wind will not carry it all away too quickly. We put straw around our watermelons, and it has not moved an inch even in very heavy rain. So let me finish this video and then we'll go have lemonade. So the next part of this project is just getting my husband to drill some very tall wooden stakes into the ground, and we're gonna start weaving in the Florida weave. Lemonade time. Well, staking up those tomatoes is gonna have to wait just a little bit longer because Big Daddy over here brought home this really neat pool. So while they are getting the sand leveled out and getting the pool in the beginning stages of filling out, I'm gonna take care of Charlene. We are right here by the barn, and the horses are hanging out there. Charlene has been battling rain rot for a long time. So I've got this new coat defense product right here. This is a daily powder that I'm gonna work into her fur. Coat? Yeah, they have fur, but we call it a coat in the horse world. No, it sounded weird. So while they're getting that done, I'm gonna do this. The tomatoes must wait. For those of you joining our channel for the first time, this is our, this is my Tennessee walking horse, Briscoe. He is a great riding buddy. It's just powder. Is it good? And he has a great personality. Not food, buddy. And this is his bestie, Charlene. Charlene was a broodmare for many years, and through several award-winning show horses. And this is her retirement home. She is now in her 20s and her golden years. And she has some hip dysplasia and some nerve things going on that we're not quite sure what they are. So we're trying our best to put weight back on her and get her coat taken care of. with some coat defense. So sorry for the little crash course in our Tennessee walking horses interrupting your tomato show, but sometimes these things come up and I thought you might like to see you know, how our day kind of ebbs and flows between gardens and animals. What do you need me to do?
This is like the worst trust exercise. I'm like ready to protect my tomato plant at any moment should that thing fall.
You good?
I'm so nervous.
The only thing to be nervous about is if this thing breaks.
All tied up. To be buying a new set of eyeballs because my husband wanted this angle.
You ready?
Are you gonna block the sun for me?
Yeah, I'm trying. Wait, there you go.
Eyeballs. Yeah. As the tomatoes grow up, we will keep adding more and more layers of twine onto it. So I think it's about time now for us to go jump in the pool. It's probably filled up. What do you think?
Probably so.
All right, that's all for today's video. We will see you guys next time.
Well, yeah.
That they're gonna do. I called a Florida weed. Why not North Carolina weed?